Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. An amazing event has just happened. The first ever female niqabi Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt. And even though I'm on the road, I said I have to take out some time to film this quick video about the great reminder and the great lesson that this historic event teaches us. Brother Muhammad Dadi told me about a month ago when his wife had received her black belt and I sent him a message to congratulate him. He told me that to the best of his knowledge, that she's the first ever Indian woman to receive her black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. And perhaps obviously the first niqabi maybe in the world. If anyone else knows any other niqabi sisters who have black belts in BJJ or any other martial arts, please let us know in the comments below so all of us can benefit. What makes this story so amazing is not just the accomplishment. Anyone who receives their black belt in BJJ, that's an amazing accomplishment. Especially we're talking about a niqabi woman here. And a lot of times we focus on that amazing accomplishment, but we forget sometimes the real lesson that this story is teaching us. And the lesson in this story that we really, really gain as Muslims, and even non-Muslims who look at Muslim women sometimes in a negative light, because what the media propagates and what the enemies of Islam have been focusing on, one of their main tactics for many years, is to say that if a Muslim woman is wearing hijab, and especially niqab, that she will be marginalized, that she will not be able to be part of society, that she will not be able to be successful in this modern world that we're living in today. But here in this story, our sister Yasmin proves once again the falsehood of their claim that when a Muslim woman has the means, even if she's in full hijab and full niqab, that she can accomplish anything, alhamdulillah. The main problem when it comes to Muslim women who are hijabis or niqabi, they're fully covered and not being able to reach their true potential and not being able to excel, the main problem comes back to us. Because we do not facilitate for them. We do not make the programs and the facilities that able them as hijabis or as niqabis to be able to excel in whatever it is they're doing. And here our brother Muhammad Dadi, may Allah bless him, when he established his dojo, his gym in Qatar, Qatar MMA, and he established a section just for women, which is completely segregated. He taught his wife and then she was able to teach the other sisters. They're in complete segregation. Therefore, they were able to excel. When Dr. Zakir Naik established his Islamic school in India, they put for the physical education program a martial arts program. And many of the students who became black belts, they were girls. And I posted on my social media accounts time and time again, pictures of our sisters who excelled in science, in engineering, in technology, all of them who were wearing niqab, not just hijab, but niqab. My wife, she trains, mashallah. She also rides horses, and she rides very fast, mashallah. And all of this in full hijab. We've even hiked and climbed to the top of a mountain in full hijab. So this misconception that they try to spread about a woman in hijab, that she can't have fun, she can't enjoy herself, she can't do sports, and she can't excel, all of this, and these type of stories that we're talking about today with Sister Yasmin getting her black belt, it proves all of this is falsehood. Wallahi, I'm so proud of my brother Muhammad Dadi and his family. And it's been a great honor for me and for my family to have been able to train under them. We ask Allah to make them an example for this ummah and to have others follow in their footsteps. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them all of the best in this life and the next.